A lot of people who live in a smart home would probably agree that automated lights are some of the most useful and regularly used automations that they have. When I talk about automated lights, I mean those that turn on and off automatically at the right color temperature and brightness when you need them to. Using your voice, or even worse, an app on your phone to turn on and off your lights does not make them smart. It's just an inconvenient switch. The most obvious way to automatically turn on your lights when you need them to is to use a little motion sensor like this. These devices detect motion really quickly, and I use them all over my house to trigger lights when someone walks into a room or up to my stairs. I also use them to pause my robot vacuum cleaner if someone walks into a room whilst it's cleaning, which stops it from barreling down on me as I'm walking up to the fridge to get a snack. But those of us who have used motion sensors to activate lights will eventually realize that they are utterly useless at knowing if a person is still in a room if they're barely moving. We've all probably been sitting in a room at a desk or watching TV, only to have the light switch off because the motion sensors haven't detected you for a while. So you end up frantically waving your arms around trying to get them to switch back on. Well, there's now a new gadget in town that solves this problem. This is an Aqara FP1 presence detection sensor, and it uses millimeter radar waves, which can detect very small amounts of movement, to accurately know if there's someone in the room or not. I've been using these for about a month now, and I'm really impressed at how accurate they are at detecting if a room is occupied or not. But whilst they accurately detect if a room is occupied or not, they take a bit of time to figure that out. In my testing, it can take 2 seconds or more before the FP1 changes its state to detected, compared with the motion sensor's almost instant response. This delay is pretty noticeable if you're relying on the FP1 to turn on the lights, and I find it really annoying. I want my lights to turn on instantly when I walk into a room, not a couple of seconds later. I also want the lights to stay on whilst I'm sitting at my desk working or slobbing around on the sofa watching TV. So I now use both of these sensors combined, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I've hooked them up to a Home Assistant sensor group to accurately and instantly detect if a room is occupied or not. When I walk into my office, the motion sensor gets triggered, which in turn sets the sensor group to presence detected as well. And the sensor group will stay in that state as long as either the motion sensor or the millimeter wave sensor detect something. Once both sensors stop detecting something, the sensor group switches back to clear. The lights now turn on instantly when I walk into the room, they stay on for as long as I'm in there, and they turn off again pretty quickly once I leave the room. Let's take a look at how I set this up in my Home Assistant configuration and how the automations now work. The Aqara FP1 is pretty hard to buy at the moment, and it's not technically available outside of China. I was lucky enough to find mine on AliExpress for about $80, but they very quickly went out of stock. The FP1 is the first commercially available presence detector that I know of that uses millimeter radar waves to map out what it can see. It does this over and over again to see if the map it made last time is different to what it can see this time, and uses that to infer if something has moved in the room. Because the radar waves are so tiny, it can detect very small amounts of movement, like someone's chest rising and falling as they breathe, or their hands as they type on a keyboard. Now, I'm no scientist, and I don't know anything at all about millimeter radar waves. There's no guarantee that this sensor isn't radiating my testicles as we speak, preventing me from ever being able to have children. But I do know that it's been really reliable at detecting whether or not a room is occupied. This particular sensor has the ability to detect presence from up to 5 meters away, and it has a 120-degree field of view horizontally and a 40-degree field of view vertically. Like most motion sensors, where you place them is really important. These sensors can detect very tiny amounts of motion, so make sure that they're pointed away from anything that might move and create a false positive, like a curtain flapping in the wind, a fan, or a fish tank. This sensor works pretty much like any other Zigbee sensor, and I was able to pair it with my Home Assistant using Zigbee to MQTT. I'm told it will also work with ZHA as of the 2022.7 Home Assistant update. Once you've added it to Home Assistant, you'll see the entities and controls that this device exposes. The one we're most interested in is the presence detection entity, which works almost the same as a normal motion sensor. I've got this normal Aqara PIR motion sensor in my office as well, and we're now going to add this and the FP1 together into a Home Assistant group. To do this, we're going to go to the Settings menu in Home Assistant, and then to the Helpers area. Create a new helper, and select the Group Helper, and then choose a binary sensor group. A binary sensor can be either on or off, or detected and not detected, which is why we're going to use this for our purpose. We can now give this group a name, and add both the motion sensor and the millimeter wave presence sensor to this group. We're going to leave the all sensors toggle as it is, which means that the group sensor will switch on or detected when any one of these sensors is triggered. If we switch this toggle, it would wait until all the sensors in the group detected presence before the group would get set to on. We can now save this group and then go back into it to change some more of the advanced settings. I like to change the type of the sensor to occupancy, which makes the icons and the values appear correctly in Home Assistant. And I also like to add it to the right area, which in this case is my office. We can now use this sensor in some really simple automations that turn the lights on when the group detects presence and off again when the group stops detecting presence. Here is the automation that I use to turn the lights on in my office when the group detects presence. The automation is triggered when the group state goes from off to on. That is, any of the sensors within the group have detected presence. The PIR motion sensor that I use also has a built-in light meter. So in this condition, I check to make sure that the brightness is less than 100 lux. I only want the lights to turn on if it's dark in the office. A second condition checks to make sure that guest mode is switched off. My office doubles as a spare bedroom, and before I had this check, the spare room lights would randomly turn on in the middle of the night if the guest got up to go to the bathroom or something. They weren't pleased. I actually did a whole video on how to make your smart home guest friendly. I've linked to that in the description below, and you should check it out after this video. If all of those conditions pass, then the automation calls the light turn on service to turn on my office lights. A similar automation works in reverse to turn the lights off again when presence is no longer detected in my office. The trigger for this automation is almost exactly the same as the one in the previous automation, except it looks for the group to go from on to off. That means that both the motion and FP1 sensors in the group have stopped detecting presence. We check for guest mode again, and if everything passes, we use the light turn off service to turn off the office lights. For good measure, I also stop any music that is playing on my office speakers by using the media player stop service. These sensors are useful for more than just lights too. If you have smart thermostats, you could easily create very similar automations that turn on and off the heating or cooling based on whether or not there are people in that room. Or you could use a combination of presence and time-based automations to open your smart curtains or blinds when you first get into a room each day. I now use these presence sensor groups to control my robot vacuum cleaner too. Each day at 11 p.m, my vacuum cleaner is scheduled to clean the kitchen. But sometimes we've got people over or we're hanging out in the kitchen late at night, and we don't want the noisy robot to start cleaning around people's feet. To prevent this, the automation checks whether or not the kitchen is occupied before it starts cleaning. If there's people in the kitchen, then it waits patiently until the kitchen presence sensor group has been set to off for at least 5 minutes. The kitchen presence sensor group is exactly the same as the one I created earlier for my office. Once we've all left the kitchen for at least 5 minutes, the robot trundles off and starts cleaning. I have another automation that gets triggered when someone comes back into the kitchen and triggers the presence sensor group. If the robot vacuum cleaner happens to be cleaning, then it will pause itself wherever it is. It will then once again wait patiently until the kitchen has been empty for at least 5 minutes, and after that it will start up again and resume cleaning. So now you know how to combine a PIR motion sensor and a millimeter wave presence sensor into a single group to get an instant but accurate representation about whether or not a room is occupied. I've actually taken it one step further in my house and combined these two sensors with the ES Presence Bluetooth tracking sensors I created in a previous video. In that video, I showed you how to track who is in what room of your house, and you can use that to trigger custom automations to set lighting, music, and climate controls to be exactly what that person prefers. If you've not seen that previous video, you should go check it out after this. I put a link in the description below. Anyway, I've combined those Bluetooth tracking sensors with the motion and FP1 sensors inside my Home Assistant configuration.yaml file. I've created a binary template sensor, which works very similarly to the group we created earlier, and it gets set to either on or off based on the states of a bunch of other sensors. You can see my office template sensor in my YAML here. It checks a bunch of sensor states, including my mobile phone, my partner's mobile phone, and my fitness tracker to see if those are currently located in my office. It also checks to see if my office PIR motion sensor or FP1 sensor have detected any presence. If any of these conditions are true, then it sets the template sensor to on, indicating that the office is occupied. I've created these sensors for all over my house, and I now have a pretty reliable foundation for creating presence-based automations not just when a room is occupied, but I can also customize those automations based on who is in what room. The main downside to this whole thing is that you need to jumble a bunch of different sensors together to get the most performant and accurate results. It would be great if someone could release a multi-sensor that combined all of these into a single device. It's definitely possible. Lewis from the Everything Smart Home YouTube channel has gone ahead and soldered together a Frankenstein's monster of a sensor that combines all of the things we just spoke about and more into a single device. Unfortunately, it involves a lot of coding, soldering, and 3D printing, so it's not something that's accessible to everyone. I'm really hoping he starts selling them, as I would sign up to buy a bunch of them immediately. You should go and check out his video, it's really cool, and I've linked to it in the description below. Would you buy one of these multi-sensors if they were available? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear where you would use it and what kind of automations you'd create with it. Whilst you're down there, why not click the subscribe button? I regularly release videos like this about smart homes, home automation, and home assistant. By clicking subscribe, you support the channel, join the community, and then together we can make your home smarter.